Remediation always occurs based on current or future land use.
Located within San Francisco's Golden Gate National Recreation Area, the Presidio offers scenic views, public parks, trails, and historic sites. It's a cleanup that involved community members, the Army, the California Regional Water Quality Control Board, the National Park Service, the Presidio Trust, and the Department of Toxic Substances Control.
The Presidio was an Army base since the late 1800s.
Until its closure in the mid-90s, the Presidio was the longest continuously running military base in the United States. But over 200 years of military use had left behind toxics and hazards that needed to be cleaned up.
The early 1990s, DTSC became the lead regulatory agency overseeing the cleanup.
The National Park Service and the Presidio Trust are the two federal agencies that manage the Presidio.
The Presidio Trust was created by an act of Congress in 1996 with the mission of managing the Presidio as a resource for all people. We do not obtain revenues from the federal government or appropriations from the federal government. The Presidio Trust took over responsibility for the remediation of the Presidio from the U.S. Army, who had been working closely with the National Park Service, our sister agency.
There were actually over 200 individual sites out at the Presidio and a whole range of concerned.
Military operations left behind multiple landfills and incinerator waste that contained a wide range of contaminants. Other hazards that needed to be cleaned up included munitions, ordnance, toxic chemicals, leaking underground petroleum pipes, pesticides, and lead paint from old Army buildings that had contaminated the surrounding soil.
Lead-based paint on a house that chipped off over time and got in the soil. So those were relatively straightforward, simple cleanups.
Cleanup of lead-based paint in soil can be straightforward, but the Presidio is a national park, which makes everything on the former base a possible historic artifact.
We were posed with a dilemma. How do we handle a historic resource that could actually be contaminated and pose a risk to human health?
Heavy equipment is used to remove contaminated soil during remediation, which could inadvertently disrupt or destroy something historic.
To make sure that those artifacts were managed correctly, we relied heavily on archaeological support in the remediation process.
Historic areas restored or preserved during the remediation can be found throughout the Presidio.
One of the resources that we found right near where we're standing is a historic dam that impounded water for the earliest inhabitants of this particular site, El Poling Springs, which were the Spanish Juana Briones and her family. And you'll see the bricks that we've placed on the ground surface that show where her original housing was located.
Protecting the past and preserving nature. Environmental restoration was a big part of the Presidio's remediation. Mountain Lake, one of only two natural lakes in San Francisco, has been renewed.
Mountain Lake is right along Highway 1 there, and it had caught a lot of runoff. So a lot of contaminants were just what was associated from runoff from the roadway. Lead and cadmium, stuff that's associated with leaded gas, petroleum, that kind of stuff had gotten in some layers of the sediments.
19,000 yards of lead and petroleum contaminated sediment was removed from Mountain Lake.
Well, they dredged the lake, removed the sediments, and now it's coming back stronger than it ever was.
The cleanup efforts overseen by DTSC provide a safe environment for people to work, live, and play. It's also helped to preserve a part of San Francisco's history. Spanning 15 years, the remediation cost $172 million. 350,000 tons of landfill waste was removed from the Presidio. The environmental restoration included 85 acres of natural habitat, 5 acres of forest, 3 acres of wetlands, as well as 26 acres of recreational and scenic areas.
The Presidio represents really a unique opportunity to enhance natural resources that are otherwise lost.
I think it's great. It's something I'm proud of, and I think the department can be proud of. I feel good about the cleanup that was done there. So I think it's a success story for the Trust, the Park Service, and DTSC.